while the 028 mine, due to its influence fusing system, does not require mechanical contact. Initiation is obtained over the full width of the fighting vehicle, which means that the initiation width has been increased by about 200%. In a minefield with conventional pressure mines, this mine density is required, with a distance between the mines of 4 meters to obtain a certain defined actuation probability. For the same actuation probability, the number of mines is reduced to a third when using the FFV-028. The reduced number of mines means that less personnel and transport resources are required, as well as less time for laying. The conventional pressure mine normally results in a mobility kill for a limited time, while the 028 mine, with its shaped charge effect, also results in a total kill, a K-kill, as the hull is penetrated. Detonation under the hull results in bottom armor penetration, considerable internal damage by blast and fragments, explosion of ammunition probable, crew out of action, repair, if at all possible, at depot. When the arming lever is pressed down and turned 90 degrees, the safety system of the mine, consisting of 2 independent safety devices, is released and the arming process starts. The shutter, the detonator safety, is released and its time mechanism starts. The battery is connected and the electronic time circuit is activated. After the expiration of the arming delay, the shutter turns to its armed position and all electronic circuits are active. The mine is armed. The arming delay is optional in manufactured, normally 15 minutes. The armed mine is surrounded by the terrestrial magnetic field. The magnetic field changes when a vehicle moves in the field. The initiation principle of the mine is to sense these changes. When a vehicle passes over the mine, the inductive sensor registers the changes of the magnetic field, resulting in a signal to the signal processing unit. The logic circuits in this unit will discriminate signals generated by irrelevant objects. When the conditions for initiation are met, an initiation pulse is emitted to the electric detonator. The uncovering charge is ignited and blows off the upper part of the mine as well as any cover over it, and therefore the shaped charge jet is unobstructed when the bursting charge detonates. Here, a road is being mined. Today's armored threat means that each soldier must be able to be used for mine laying. Mine laying is simple. After placing the mine, only 2 operations are required: removal of the transport safety and arming. Simple handling has been an essential requirement during the development phase. The mine is corrosion resistant and therefore well suited for mining of watercourses. It may be placed at a depth of down to 2 meters with retained reliable function. To lay realistic minefields during maneuvers and other exercises, there is a practice version of the FFV-028 mine. To score when the practice mines are initiated, the mine has a smoke cartridge. The operations required to arm the practice mine are the same as for the live mine. We will now follow some test firings from the development of the mine. This is a target arrangement representing the track unit of a heavy tank. Detonates under the track of a medium tank. From a test where the target consisted of an APC, the mine under the hull. All hatches and doors were locked and reinforced with steel beams. This is a radio-controlled tank, filmed in slow motion. The operator guides the tank with its center line over the buried mine towards the direction post. Perforated the bottom armor. Considerable internal damage, for instance, gearbox and transmission completely destroyed. The hole in the ground shows that the tank, due to its inertia, has continued a few meters after the detonation. Is well suited for mining missions in various tactical situations. Due to the simple handling, mine patrols can be formed from all units. The instructions required to handle the mine can be given in a short time. Here, mines are laid hastily by a mine patrol. The mines are not buried. Clearing of the 028 mine difficult, it may be provided with a built-in booby trap device. When the position of the mine is altered during clearing, manually or mechanically, this is sensed by the booby trap device, which produces a signal and the mine detonates. The signal processing unit of the mine, both with booby trap device and without this device, prevents the mine from detonating through the shock waves from nuclear explosion, or artillery fire, or Bangalore torpedoes. The mine cover is designed with lugs, facilitating stacking of the mines, valuable, for instance, when loading mines in a mine layer. The mine can be laid from vehicles, like this, with retained reliability. The FFV-028 mine is an effective component in the defense against the armored enemy, owing to the reduced response time for mine laying and the total kill capability. The mine gives all units a significant anti-armor capacity.